How to get the best TV picture settings out of your PlayStation 5 for any TV or monitor. Hey everyone, how's it going? Welcome back to the channel. In today's episode, I want to walk through with you how to get the best possible TV settings from your PlayStation 5 to your TV or monitor, no matter which one you're set up and connected to. As always, if you enjoy any part of this video or find it helpful, please let me know by dropping a like down below. And if you're new to this channel, this is the spot where you'll find the latest tips, tricks, and strategies to help you get the most out of your PlayStation gaming experience. Feel free to subscribe down below so you can watch more helpful PlayStation videos just like these. Let's get right into it. First up, before you even start setting up your TV to optimize its settings with the PlayStation 5, you need to make sure that you have an HDMI cable that's rated for high speed and certified by HDMI. If you don't have an HDMI high speed cable, then you won't allow the proper bandwidth to be pushed through the HDMI cable to allow for the best picture performance between the PS5 and your TV or monitor. This includes not just performance picture features like color and contrast, but also for features like frame rate as well. The HDMI cable that comes with the PlayStation 5 right out of the box is rated for high speed, but in case something happens to it or you lose it and you need a new one, you want to make sure that that HDMI cable is rated for high speed. Now that we got that out of the way, we can finally start getting into the TV and adjusting the picture settings. The best place to check on your picture settings through your PlayStation 5 is through the Video Output Information Center, and that's up here with the gear icon, which is the settings menu of the PlayStation 5. You want to go into that, and then you want to go down to where it says screen and video. And then once you go into the screen and video menu, then the first one up there is video output information. Once you go into video output information, this is the current readout of your resolution, your color, and if the HDR is currently supported on your TV or monitor. What you then want to do with the PlayStation 5 readout is you want to match it up with the picture readout from the TV itself. And the way to do that on newer LG C10 OLED TVs, or CX as the logo says, is to mash this green button a bunch of times until the readout comes out. But depending on your manufacturer of TV, like I think Samsung, the readout is actually on the bottom and it's through the picture setting itself. When you push that button and you finally find your TV's readout, you want to make sure that the readout matches what the PlayStation 5 is telling you that the video output currently is. So for me, I have 4K or 3840 by 2160 by 60 hertz or frames per second. And that does match up with my FreeSync information, which is 3840 by 2160 at 60 frames or hertz. And then you also want to double check that it is matched up with the RGB or HDR. It says that it is confirmed that it is running RGB at 12-bit color. And we have the readout of RGB HDR over here. If you're curious seeing that it says fixed up here, the reason why that is Sony currently doesn't support variable refresh rate on the PlayStation 5. Although they did say that they will come out with a firmware update later on this year that will support variable refresh rate or the ability to increase or decrease frame rate during a game instantaneously. So newer TVs like the LG C10 OLED and other manufacturers as well do support variable refresh rate. Once Sony pushes that firmware update to your console, it should match up with your information tab saying that it's at a variable refresh rate as well. Going back into the main screen and video settings menu, if you have a newer 4K HDR TV and you're first setting up your PlayStation 5 for the first time, you want to leave all these settings on automatic. The only times you want to change it or double check on it is if the color is off or if you're experiencing screen blackness or blinking. Now, if you do have an older TV or monitor, you do want to go back into these settings and make sure that they match the specs that are reading out on your display. So for instance, if you have a 1080 or 720p resolution monitor TV, you want to go back and you want to change it to match that so that it does read 720 or 1080. If you leave it at automatic, that's okay, but if you're having any issues, it could be because the PlayStation 5 is trying to push too much bandwidth through that high-speed HDMI cable into your TV, and the TV or monitor is just simply not supporting that extra bandwidth. If you changed your resolution and you're still experiencing some weird glitchy issues for your picture, you can go down to 4K video transfer rate And this one's for the 4K monitors and TVs. You can slightly bump down the transfer rate of the 4K video signal that's being pushed from the PlayStation to the TV. And the slower you push that through, the less bandwidth that's going through the HDMI cable and the less signal that your TV has to process. So if you experience any kind of picture flickering, you go back into the 4K video transfer settings and try one or two under and see if that helps smooth out the picture for you. I would also turn off HDR and not leave it on automatic if you don't have an HDR supported monitor or TV. And that should be done by default, but you want to come back and double check if that is the case. Otherwise, if you do have an HDR compatible display, you do want to make sure that that's on automatic. And if you go in here, you'll see that a full on isn't even supported yet. It just says automatic or off. Once you set your HDR on automatic for a supported display, you then want to adjust the HDR coloring to make sure that it's as natural and true as possible. And you do that by going into the adjust HDR menu. And then you'll be shown some images that you go into where you have to adjust the display that's on there so that you barely recognize it, but just enough so that you can still pick out the detail in each one. Now for this example, I'm leaving things a little brighter so that I can make it show up better on this YouTube video for you, but I would generally lower it quite a bit more, or in this case raise it, so that I can just barely see the outline and details of the sun picture. And this is a fairly standard process now that they're trying to set across all displays and devices so that colors are as natural and true as possible from the developers, which is really cool. You'll be met with two more menus like this to show contrast, brightness, and depth. If you have your HDR set to automatic, you have to always have deep color output set to automatic as well. On isn't an option again, and then off actually will turn off HDR altogether. So you have to have deep color output set to automatic. Now, like this LG C10 OLED TV, if you have a newer 4K TV or monitor, you may need to make sure and double check that the picture settings within the TV itself matches up with the deep color output confirmation of the PlayStation 5. So for this TV, you need to go into the picture settings. And then once you're in picture, you want to go down to where it says additional settings. And then here you want to check on three things. The first one being HDMI Ultra HD Deep Color. Other manufacturers have different names for it, like Enhanced Deep Color or Enhanced Mode. So make sure that that name coincides with this option. But if you go into it, you want to confirm that the HDMI input that you have set for your PlayStation 5 currently connected to also matches up that it's on with the Ultra HDMI Deep Color. And what that does is that helps with the depthness of the color that's output by the deep color output of the PlayStation 5. If you have one on, like the deep color output, but you had Ultra HD Deep Color set off on your TV, the colors will look different and off, and you'll notice that something needs to be changed. When I turned on that Ultra HD Deep Color on the TV itself, the settings matched up and the colors really did start to pop and look really good. I mention this on pretty much every YouTube video that I make about pictures or visuals for your PlayStation 5, and that is you want to make sure that game mode or any game related mode within your settings is always set to on. And that's because any increase in input lag can significantly decrease the quality of your gaming experience on your PlayStation. So like the ultra deep HDMI color, you go into this menu and make sure that that setting is set to on for the HDMI that you're currently connected to for the PlayStation 5 and your TV or monitor. If your TV supports FreeSync technology from AMD, you also wanna make sure that that's set to on and confirm that it's the HDMI port that's connected from the PlayStation 5 to your TV or monitor. If you try all those things and you see that the colors and contrasts of the picture are just not showing up correctly, you can go into the RGB range and adjust it to make sure that the colors are matching up with what the TV is showing. And you can choose between limited, full, or automatic. Limited or full will lock it in at that rate. So if there's a game that wants to show certain limitations or fullness of color, it won't be able to change the range, such as like automatic does. Where you might notice this change in setting more severely is for video streaming apps like Disney Plus, Netflix, or Hulu that don't support some of these RGB ranges. If you have the wrong RGB range set, you'll see that some of like the red colors will like look more like a pale orange. blues look more pale, things like that, instead of like a deep true color. If you see that, make sure you go back here and confirm that the RGB range is set to automatic before you go back into those apps and start streaming your videos again. To add to this, some video streaming apps still do not support HDR, like PlayStation 4 and PlayStation 5 games are starting to incorporate. So if you find that the colors are off, you'll also want to go back here to the HDR menu and make sure that that's off so that the colors don't look weird or washed out. But if you know you're about to play a PlayStation 4 or PlayStation 5 game that does support HDR, make sure to come back here and turn it back on again. If you're ready to play a 4K 120 frame per second PlayStation 5 game and you have a newer 4K TV or monitor that does support this higher frame rate, I recently published a video and I'll leave it up here and down in the description below that walks you through the necessary settings that you need to turn on in order to enable that faster frame rate from your PlayStation 5. I also share my thoughts on the differences between 4K 60 frames per second and 4K 120 frames per second, including things like color, performance, picture, contrast, etc. So be sure to check that video out. As always, if you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, please be sure to hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe so that you can always stay up to date on my latest helpful PlayStation videos just like these. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you on the next video.